Alright, so in this quick video, I will show you how to use polars right inside Excel, and it's actually much easier than you might think. All we need is an Excel add-in called xlwings lite. So, to install it, go to your home tab and then click on add-ins. Here you want to search for xlwings lite. Now in my case, I already have it installed as you can see here, but in your case, if you haven't installed it yet, it should show up somewhere here on the search results and then just click on the add button. Now once you install it, xlwings lite should open automatically, but you can also open it manually by clicking on this icon here. Now with xlwings lite, you can run Python code directly in Excel. And the special thing here is that you don't have to install Python on your machine, because it uses PyoDite in WebAssembly. That means everything runs in a sandbox environment in your browser. So you don't have to worry about any Python setup, you just install the add-in, which is free by the way, and then you can run Python directly in Excel. Now here you will see some example code on how to use xlwings lite. Now I already made an introduction video to show you how to use xlwings lite, and you can find that video somewhere here. However, for this video I will keep it brief because I just want to show you how to use polars in Excel. So for that, let me just delete all the example code here. And then I will just copy some example from my clipboard and paste it right in here. And in just a second, of course, I will explain the code. But first you will see we've got a little error message because currently we don't have the polars module installed. And to fix it is actually quite simple. So all we need to do is to go to the requirements tab here. And down here I will add a new dependency, which is our polars package. Now as you can see here, we might actually need to reload the add-in. So to do that, just click on here and click on reload. Alright, so once it's reloaded, we can test it out. So here I created a new Excel function called topProduct by Rechem, and it will take a polars data frame as an input. Then I will do some calculations and then I will return the result. So let me show you what we are getting here. So I will search for the new function, which is topProduct by Rechem, and now all I need to do is to select all my data here and press enter. And now you can see we've got the total revenue for each region. So this is basically the calculation I'm doing here because currently we only have the unit sold and the unit price. So here I'm just multiplying the columns and it will be my new column, which is revenue. Then I will group my data by the region and sum up all the revenue for all the regions. Once I've done that, I can also sort my result by the total revenue in descending order. And here you can now see the final result. Yeah, and this is basically how you can use polars right inside Excel. Now, once again, you don't need to have Python installed on your machine to run this code. All you need is the Excel add-in, and then you can just enter your Python code right in here. And this Python code is now also stored inside the workbook. So that means every time you open this workbook, you will have this code available if you click on the xlwings lite button. Also, once again, this is just one small example. If you want to go a little bit more fancy, you can also do that with xlwings lite. So for that, let me import xlwings as xw. Then I will also import script, as well as matplotlib. Alright, so once we have that, let me also paste in some other example code I have written before. So here now, instead of the function decorator, I'm using the script decorator. And by doing this, we will now have a new button here, which is a sales summary and chart. So this is basically now my script. Now when you click on it, you will now see that we've got a new sheet, which is a summary sheet, where we've got the revenue summary by product, and also we've got a little chart here. And to create all of this, we just need a couple of lines. So here as a first step, I'm reading in my sales data. So if I go back to my sales data sheet, I'm using this current workbook and my sheet is sales data. From there, I want to get the source, so it's A1, and I'm expanding my table here. So basically, I'm getting this whole table here, and I want to read it as a polars data frame, because xlwings lite supports polars as we just have seen. So once I have all my data and polars, I can do all the calculations we have seen before. After that, I will just create a new sheet, which is called summary. Now first, I'm actually checking if the sheet is already available, and if not, I will just add the sheet to my workbook. After that, I will do some styling, so that means if I go back to summary here, in cell A1, we will have the title revenue summary, which you can see here. And then you can also adjust the properties, like making it bold, changing the font size, or changing the font color. After that, I will insert my summary, which we have created with polars, in the cell A3. So that's the reason here you can now see the summary table. And lastly, I'm just creating the chart with matplotlib and inserting this chart here as an image in the cell E3. So that's the reason here this is the anchor, cell A3. Alright, and that's basically it. Once again, this was just a really quick video to show you how to use polars in Excel. However, if you want to learn more about xlwings and how to use it, then once again, check out this video here. Alright, and with that, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Cheers!